Step 1. To begin, make sure the latest version of the Flumos mobile application is downloaded from the Google Play Store on your Android mobile device. The version must be V01.10R06 or newer. Step 2. Be sure the contamination monitor is correctly positioned in a vertical orientation where the direction of flow is south to north. Note, the contamination monitor must be receiving flow at the time of connection. Step 3. Connect the 8-pole M12x1 communications and power cable to the contamination monitor and the opposite end to the corresponding sensor 1 input of the CSI C11 condition sensor interface module. Step 4. Connect the 5-pole M12x1 end of the power supply adapter to the CSI C11 condition sensor interface module. Step 5. Connect the opposite end of the power supply adapter to a suitable electrical receptacle. Step 6. Open your Android's mobile device settings and connect to the wireless network HiDAC_AP once it becomes available. Step 7. Open the Flumos mobile application, wait until the LED on the CSI C11 has changed from amber to green, and select the Wireless Land Area Network Connection icon to wirelessly connect to the CSI C11 Condition Sensor Interface module. At this point, the Flumos mobile application should immediately connect to the CSI C11 and data measurements will automatically begin recording. If the devices fail to connect, refer to troubleshooting step 7.A. If the devices connect successfully, but the LED on the CSI C11 is illuminating red, refer to troubleshooting step 7B. If troubleshooting steps 7A and 7B do not help solve your connection problems, please refer to the user manual or contact Schroeder Industries technical support at sisales@schroederindustries.com. Step 8. The CSI C11 will begin logging data measurements upon successful connection to the contamination monitor. The individual measurement points are collected into a log. Each log is given a name and a date time signature. To transfer a data log, select the desired data log followed by the download icon. The data log will now be downloaded to your device, where it will exist under the mobile tab. Step 9. To transfer the data to your personal computer, select the data log under the mobile tab, followed by the export icon. You may export the data as either a data file or a CSV file, or both data file and CSV file formats. The data file is compatible only with the Flumos Lite software, where the data can be automatically tabulated and graphed for rate of change trending purposes. The CSV files can be viewed in most spreadsheet programs, but will only be transferred as raw data. Users of the CSV file type will be able to create their own tables and rate of change metrics. Step 10. Once the file types have been chosen, you may select the export destination and transfer the data log files. Step 7A. If the devices fail to connect, check the LED on the CSI C11 module. If the LED is illuminated red, a processing error has occurred. Disconnect all cables and begin from step 1. Step 7B. If the devices connect successfully, but the LED on the CSI C11 module is illuminating red, select the settings icon followed by the device settings icon. In device settings, you will be able to adjust the smart sensor count, device address, and save time. Be sure the smart sensor count is set to 1 and the device address is set to A. Save time allows you to adjust the duration between data measurements. Select the OK icon to save your settings and the device will automatically restart. Proceed to step 7.